Yes.
Why did I form so many different bands? Yes. You need another drink. The reason that we brought Stone Sour back was because, as much as I love Slipknot, and I'm devoted to Slipknot in every way, I am still a songwriter. I'm still a guy who's gonna wanna write my own songs. And at the time, I wasn't getting to play enough of my own music. That's because I'm, you know, for the most part, Jim and Mick are fantastic guitar players, and there's no way I'm gonna fucking be able to keep up with them when it comes to riffs like that. And Paul. Paul was so far beyond when it came to guitar playing. So I knew that I wasn't gonna be able to write a lot of music in Slipknot. Like, I could contribute lyrically. I could, you know, help arrange stuff. And I can, you know, come up with the melodies and whatnot like that. But I knew that if I wanted to do my own stuff, I was going to have to put Stone Sour back together, which is what we did at the end of the day. And actually, it made more sense to do that than to start something that might not have been as near to my heart, you know? I mean, Stone Sour was the first real band that I ever started back in 2002. Long fucking time ago. Next year's 20 years. You're gonna need to give me a minute. Yeah, I am old as shit. I can feel it in my knees and my balls every morning. So yeah, I mean, the simple question is that there's a lot of music that I want to make. There's a lot of music I still can't make with either band. So I end up starting weird shit like JB Cavey, just to be able to do, you know, weirder shit still. So yeah, I mean, as long as I'm writing music, I'm gonna find a way to get it out there because I just don't know how to do it.
Yeah.
What's that?
Second floor.
Weirder things. Let's just say I have an R&B album in me somewhere, but not that fucking R&B. I mean, like, real school fucking R&B, like. Fucking Otis Redding, just that fucking. That man's